Hey, Austin Smallwood, your SCR Director of Legal and Regulatory Affairs outside the Real Estate Commission, where we just wrapped up a 6-hour meeting. Licensee numbers in the state continue to rise at about 500 a month. We're up to almost 45,000 licensees statewide. SCR CEO Nick Kramitis addressed the commission today to talk about a few issues affecting the industry. The first issue was the inclusion of FEMA claims on the property disclosure. Currently, our property disclosure does not include this data. This is important since the state of South Carolina has had an emergency declaration the last 4 years due to flooding or hurricane damage. FEMA claims run with the property and not with the individual property owner, and after a particular property has gotten several of these claims, the property may be uninsurable or have astronomical insurance rates. We believe this is important information for a prospective homeowner to know and something that should be readily apparent to the current owner of the property. Nick also addressed with the commission the growing use of alternate names or nicknames in the real estate profession. As many of you know, our current license law does not allow for an individual to use a nickname or an alternate name, as license law states that you must practice under the name that's on your real estate license. This law, we believe, is way too broad, encompasses people who use common nicknames such as Bill for William, people who go by their middle name instead of their first name, and women who have recently changed their name due to marriage. The commission seemed awfully receptive to Nick. We're trying to see if we can address it either through the regulation task force that the commission has set up or through legislation in January. They also had application hearings this month at the Real Estate Commission. The Real Estate Commission alternates between application hearings and disciplinary hearings every month. So this particular month they had application hearings. These are hearings in which an applicant for a real estate license had some red flag that appeared during their background check or in their application process. There were 9 such hearings this month. 7 of the individuals were granted the right to sit for the real estate exam, 2 individuals were not. The 2 individuals who were not granted the right to sit for the real estate exam were not granted the right due to having an extended criminal background history, having the charges in front of the commission be relatively recent, or having the individual still being on probation or owing restitution. That wraps up this month's LLR update. If you have any additional questions, feel free to call the legal hotline or email Byron or myself. Until next month, see you then.